In the previous video, we learned how to configure the data using FlexB behavior. Before using it to configure the states in our state machine for picking a part, let us understand better what is a FlexB state and what property it has to interface with the behavior. Remember that a state encapsulates an atomic action in the behavior, and that ROS nodes provide robot capabilities through topics, services, or actions. We have to compose our behavior using these generic capabilities. Well, a FlexB state is then a concrete use of one or more of these capabilities in our ROS system to perform the specific action. For example, the move group has the capability to plan and execute motions in a robot manipulator. Well, one state can then be the action to command the move group to execute a motion to reach a specific position. In our state machine, we already have two of such states, one that moves the robot one to the pick configuration, and another one that moves it to its home configuration. Okay. Now that we have clarified the idea of a state in relation to a ROS application, let's see how this is implemented by the different elements of a state in FlexB. On the right, you have the dialog that appears when you click on a state. For example, the state compute pick configuration. First of all, the state has a name that describes what action is performed. We already saw this when we created our states in the previous video. This is something you define as a user for your application. So use a name that is clear and unambiguous. For example, don't name a state simply compute or move, because probably in your behavior, you will compute or move multiple times, and you will need to distinguish between those states. The next element is the state implementation. This is the class compute_grasp_state we chose when we added this specific state. And here you also have the description of what this class of state does. In the final module of this week, we will discuss in detail state implementations of these classes, and you will learn to code your own basic state implementation. Okay. After the state implementation, we have required autonomy levels, but let's ignore them. We will not use them in this course. They allow an operator to control the activation of the state during behavior execution. Okay, the following elements are very important. They are the interface to this state implementation. We use these elements to configure the state implementation in our state machine. By giving values to them, our state will execute the specific action we need the way we want for our particular behavior. The interface of a state consists of three elements. The parameters define the properties of the state that are constant during the behavior execution. Then the input and output key mappings define the runtime data that the state needs as an input and the data it produces as an output, respectively. Finally, the outcomes define the possible results of the execution of the state. They are not shown in this view, but in the state machine editor, remember, we already use them to connect the state with the following states depending on each outcome. Let's see in detail how we configure all these values for the states in our pick behavior. We will start with the state parameters. We have already said that the parameters allow you to configure the static properties for a particular behavior, that is, the properties that remain constant during the execution. For example, for our compute pick state, the group parameter defines for which group our state will compute the join configuration to pick the part. To assign a value to a state parameter, we can directly use a literal value by using quotation marks. In this case, we want to pick the part with robot one. So we set the value of this parameter to robot one. With the mouse over, we get information about the parameter. In this case, the value has to be a string. Okay, but wait. State parameters are constant, and we have already seen how to define constant values for our behavior, remember? It was in the previous video. We defined them in the private configuration. We have already created a variable pgroup with the name of the group for picking. So we can use it instead of the literal value to configure the parameter group in the state. There is a useful autocompletion that shows us the variables that are available. So we choose pgroup. This way, if we want to change the robot we use in this behavior, we will only need to change the value of our behavior variable instead of the values of all the state parameters that refer to it. Okay. The next element of a state are the input and output keys. The input keys define the data that we need to pass to the state for its execution, and the output keys define the data that is produced by the state. For example, our state compute pick configuration takes as input the pose of the part as a pose stamp message, and it produces a float array with the join configuration to pick it, and a string array with the join names. In contrast with the state parameters, the value of the data in the input and output keys can vary during runtime. They are read by the state implementation every time it becomes active. Input and output keys are used in combination with the behavior user data. Remember that user data are variables that hold runtime information. So, for the value of an input key, we use the user data variable that contains that information. In our example, we set the pose input key to be the part pose user data that we define to contain the pose of the part we want to pick. The autocompletion also shows us the available user data variables. Okay, now we set the output key joint values to the user data pick configuration in order to collect the joint values to be passed as input for the next state that will move the robot. And we can leave the joint names with the default value. Okay, we have defined the input and output keys for the compute pick configuration state. Finally, the last element of the state interface are the state outcomes that we have already mentioned multiple times. As we have said, the outcomes define the possible results of executing a state. Each outcome can be connected to a different state to transition to, if obtained. So they define the possible transitions from the state. For example, our compute pick configuration state has two possible outcomes: continue and failed. Remember, we connected the continue outcome to the next state in our behavior, so that once the join configuration for picking is computed, the next state becomes active and moves the robot to it. And we connected the failed outcome directly to the failed result of the behavior. We can see that the outcomes of all the states shape the possible execution flows in the state machine. All right. To wrap up, in this video, we have explained all the properties of FlexB states that we will use in this course: the name, the implementation or class, the parameters, the input and output key mappings, and the outcomes. Now, we are ready to complete the configuration of our pick behavior. Check the next video to learn how.